Good evening. It's wonderful to see you all here. I'm Alicia Ostreicher, and I am thrilled and honored to be introducing Rigoberto González, who has won the Lenore Marshall Prize for the most outstanding book of poetry published in the United States in the previous year. As you can imagine, this was difficult to judge. And we are all thrilled by the choice. If you love to read, you know and love the experience of feeling from the very opening of a book that you are in the hands of a master. I'd like to read the opening, share with you the opening of Rigoberto González's Unpeopled Eden, just because I want the sound of it in my own voice. It's called The Soldier of Mictlan, and it begins like this. Once upon a time, there was a soldier who marched to Mictlan in his soldier boots, and every step was a soldier step, and every breath was a soldier word. Do you know what this soldier said? I'd like a piece of bread for my soldier hand. I'd like a slice of cheese for my soldier nose. Do you feel that? The stamp of it, the confidence of it, and the fact that the repetition of soldier reminds us that we don't know what we think about soldiers. And when the mayor of Mictlan, which is the Aztec land of the dead, explains that there is no bread or cheese here, but that they can hold and smell each other's hands, you have a little taste of the essence of González's craft, a craft that is a biting blend of folklore and myth and history, magic realism, language that is both straight ahead and surreal at the same time, sensuous and harsh, like a foot falling on the only daisy left standing after the cow stampede. Painfully elegiac and also comic, wounded and broken, and at all times under the wounds and under the brokenness, deeply tender. Author of 4 volumes of poetry, 2 bilingual children's books, a novel, a book of stories, and a memoir, winner of many prizes, González in Unpeopled Eden writes of family, of the land, of exile, of deportation, abandonment. There are men, women, and children's lives in this book, and their deaths offered to us in language that flashes with surprise around the corner of every line break. Please join me in welcoming Rigoberto González.
Buenas noches. And I'm so moved. I'm speechless. I had a joke that I was going to open with, and it just flew out of my head. But I do want to thank Kwame, Alicia, and Susan for looking very kindly upon this child of migrant farm workers who my father wanted me to become a boxer, my mother wanted me to become an engineer, and I think I found a way to mix those two visions together in poetry. I'm just going to read. Morti vivos docent, let the dead teach the living. In the trunk, a blouse with breasts, a skirt stretched open by hips that have shaken off the last whiff of talcum powder at the pothole. Clumsy dancer, dropping a shoe somewhere between Mexicali and Calexico. If she were breathing, she'd let the whiskey tell the tale. Sultry syllable after sultry syllable. Si, mi amor. Mummies are this century's mermaids, rattling songs that will stop a heart if we let them, says the whale-eyed sailor, hands cuffed to the steering wheel, mumbling the madness of a man who found a woman whistling beneath a Mexican moon. Music so pretty, he just had to keep it from ruining the terrorist world. This is how you ruin the terrorist world. Cut out the yellow heart of heaven. Drop the bloodless stars into the sea. Blind the women who sit to wonder on the shore. I knew such a woman. I've kept her comb in my purse after all these years, since the night my father found her walking home from the Cachanilla Hills. You know the names, El Abanico, El Dólar, La Puta Eva, y El Pinchadán, places so plump with pleasure, even the air turns to stupor, drunk with a sensory coma. Clarification, she was not the body in the ruby corset, not behind the pair of tassels, not inside the scent of tangerines. My mother was a mop in the bucket, wiping off the fingerprints on the promiscuous wall. This is how you press against a promiscuous wall. Drill the pair of diamonds on your back and moan. Hold your breath. Float face down on the vertical pool. Sway with the shadow set in motion by a swinging chandelier. An angry father come to claim his child. He did not catch me then, but he caught me walking home, my knees still numb from dancing with the men who love their mamacitas pink and puckered as if they're sipping wine transparent as the cloth across their thighs. What could I do with lips like mine but kiss or whistle loud enough to be the visible woman my overworked mother never was? So papi, keep your only son holy as you stuff me in the trunk. I'm wearing mother's blouse, my mother's skirt. La pelona is bird woman, and pelona is a term, I think, attributed to Frida Kahlo. It's her name for Lady Death. La pelona es bird woman. Tonight, I dare to crawl beneath the sheets to be nailed down around me, waiting for my lover, she who enters without knocking, she who will unstitch my every seam along my thigh, my side, my armpit, she who carves a heart out of the heart and drops it down her throat. Sweet surrender this slow death in sleep as I dream the lovemaking is autopsy. How else will I be hers completely? Be her treasure box, I said, a trove of pearls and stones, the ding of coins cascading through her fingers. The bird over her shoulder, not a parrot, but an owl to be my mirror when I close my eyes and shape a moon-white bowl out of my face where she can wash the hooks of her caress. Still, with water, I'm one more thing to penetrate. I'm one more spill of secrets on the floor. A puddle glowing green, she doesn't have to be a sleuth to see I've taken all the antifreeze. A puddle thick with red, she'll kneel next to my wounds and pray for me. A string of pigeon skulls, her rosary. By dawn, our bone Pieta breaks out of its shadow, unleashes its cicada cry. My daughters drag their bodies, bruised as bats, out to the light and burst into flames like marigolds. The crows will leap down from the trees to pick them clean. And my beloved bride, beloved wife, will laugh until it hurts her teeth. It's the feather of her tongue, 11th finger, I recall, and not the catheter, while the priest recites his holy dribble and the churchyard worker takes a leak. My sons hold up their chins with pride that they have done their part to hide my suicide. They've clipped my fingertips to lose a track back to my prince. But my beloved knows. She crouches on the highest branch and drops an egg that cracks my coffin. Concussion light squirms through, and I'm in heaven once again. Those times we screwed like hen and rooster, I the squawking chicken blacking out, and she the hammering cock. Muchísimas gracias. Buenas noches.